Hey all, and welcome to Spike's Day Out. This is the second game. The one we played before was Spike's Day Off. And we are now going to play another short Spike game from the creators of Daydreaming Derby. But I think they actually made these games before they made Daydreaming Derby. And they are going to make a game called Spike's Time Off, which is why we're playing these, to just sort of get in the groove. I don't know when they will release Spike's Time Off, but I think it's sometime this summer. At least I'm hoping. Alright, let's get started. Phew! What is that thing? It looks like a petrified pony with an onion for a head. Maybe. Alright. I really got it from Twilight. But what? Who said that? I did! Oh, it's Coco Pomelo. Hey, I remember you from Manhattan. Yeah, I'm Spike. What are you doing here, Coco Pomelo? I'm here for the PonyCon subculture convention today. Thought you would have noticed. What with all the ponies in cosplay? Were you here for it too? Oh no, I got lost. I didn't know there was a convention out here. Well, it's good that you're here. Could you help me out of this thing? What is that thing anyways? I'm actually here to work at an event later in the day. And I'm supplying these replica suits of armor for it. Oh, it's a suit of armor. It still looks like an onion head. You made this? I thought you were just a costume designer. I work on commission. I even made some on-the-spot fixes for a few ponies here. I can't help but feel responsible for all the costumes here. And this one was already falling apart. But then there's the rest of the armory back home I need to finish. Nothing a little foam and hot glue won't fix, right? Sounds like a busy schedule for you. Did you need some help with that? Oh, I can't ask for your help. Besides, I'm sure your friends need you more than I do. No, they don't. They'll be fine without me. Is something wrong? Actually, I need to get a gift for some pony. Now that you mentioned it, I might need some assistance with the event later. Employees for you to get a free ticket to any Broadway show. That's perfect. Twilight loves musicals. Where is it? It's inside the convention center, up the stairs. But I think you'll need a badge to get inside. Sure, I can join you. Thanks, here's a little something for you. Got a fancy looking hat. Click X to equip and C to take it off. It's a hat for Vic Nalentine, not Nick Valentine, cosplayer was working on. Wearing it will make you look inconspicuous. You'll be able to overhear other ponies' conversations. Sometimes eavesdropping on ponies can help you do things. Might even help you be more stealthy too. I'll put it to good use. Don't look at the time, I really need to get back to work. See you at the Elegant Princess Tea Party later. Wait, what? So... Was that a Fallout reference for Nick Valentine? Wasn't he the... synth detective? I think he was. So... Also, is this game teaching me to eavesdrop and that's a good thing? The suit of armor is blocking the door. Oh, it's Link. It should be a convention exclusively for waiting in lines. Deadpool and Harlequin. I think that's Harlequin. Yeah, that must be it. Maybe. Who knows? Need a badge to get in, but I'm not about to wait in a line all day. Alright. So, is that Trixie, and what are you dressed up as? Stomach growl. That's all? Alright. And we have the TARDIS. Oi, police telephone Republic. Didn't know they still had these. Probably don't. Alright. Ice cream. Pretty sure the guy next to me stole my waffle cones. Oh, that's eavesdropping, right, so if I take it off, what do you say? You get a free waffle cone, if I had any here. Alright, so you get different dialogue depending on whether you have the hat on or not. I got a hot dog. Don't worry, it's vegan. Was the other hot dog in the other game vegan? I wonder. I need to look inconspicuous to get food here. So, what if I don't? Because then I can't even interact with it. Right, but I have a hot dog now. Cardboard boxes are the highest form of stealth. That's good, Metal Gear Solid Snake thing. I could totally snatch that hot dog off the counter over there. And they said I couldn't barbecue corn. He's saying the same thing. So, there's a little sign down here that says closed. Bubble tea! Pay no mind to the flashing lights under the truck. I will do that. They have no mind whatsoever. Name any exotic flavor. I got it here. Alright, put on the hat again. Oh, I got a hot dog. Not sure how that's gonna help us with the huge line that wasn't really that huge. It was like three ponies. So, you're hungry. So if I give you a hot dog, grow. Trixie should really eat breakfast instead of just waiting for lunch. Trixie? Grumble. How may Trixie help you, convention goer? Are you working here? Wait a minute. You're a dragon from back in Philadelphia. Well, you'll be glad to know Trixie is now living back in Canterlot. Oh, so I did play them in the right order. I was worried about that. I can see you've picked up a day job since then. This is only temporary employment for the weekend. It's not like Trixie was strong-armed into being here. Uh-huh, sure. By the way, did you want something to eat? I could hear your stomach across the street. Food? For me? Yeah, here's a hot dog for you. Dot dot dot. Trixie, you okay? You're hired. What? I mean, we could use some extra claws at our staff here. We could even get you inside for free too. Not like Trixie is extremely grateful for your kindness. So, thanks. The convention sponsor is in that blue booth over there. You could get a badge from her. Alright, I'll check it out. Alright, does that mean we get to see Derby? Who turned out the lights? Spike! Yes? That's... Spike? Isn't that the Alicorn amulet? Don't you dare step out that door. This isn't funny. You have to tell me what's wrong. Did I do something to offend you? Yes. Oh, it's Celestia. Hop, hop. Spike! You might want to watch the entrance there. We're in a pocket dimension, so it may be temporarily unstable. Are you alright? I'm okay. It's actually quite quaint in here. Wait, Princess Celestia? It's a nice surprise to see you too. What is that in your mouth? Is that a swirly vortex of doom? It might be. Also, one of your eyebrows is very squiggly wiggly. And please, we are both at a convention to indulge ourselves. There's no need to defer to me. That's some nice cosplay. Oh, you wouldn't believe how hard it was to put all this together. It has to be original, but not out of character. At first I had 12 outfits to choose from, but there was one problem. What was it? There are only 3 days for the convention, and I want to wear them all, for the sake of law implications. So I decided to mash up 4 outfits for each day. Genius, right? Oh, well... Right. Thinking not a good idea, Princess. Doctor. Excuse me. Are you the sponsor Trixie was talking about? Ah, yes. Were you joining our staff today? Yeah, I was sent here to get my badge. There you go, welcome to the team. I now have a staff badge. Careful, no replacements. Now I can get inside the convention center. Before you go, here are the rules and regulations. Oh boy. 1. Risk B? respect for all the fandoms. Ape to say so. Because every pony has a life outside the convention. Basic etiquette. Okay. Number two, have fun. Because life outside the convention won't allow it. Oh, that's terrible. Reality check. Got it. Alright. Still have a fancy hat though. Go forth and be your bad self. That's the same. Right. Let me wear the hat. Right, I can now enter the convention. There we go. We are now at PonyCon. The sleeping guy over there looks kind of thirsty. What sleeping guy over there? Oh, there. The lifeblood of conventions, the water fountain. Well, if he's thirsty, he is like right there. And I guess I can't go over here. Go up here then. Oh, there's Coco. Hey Spike, you ready for the Elecon Princess Tea Party? I don't know. Nothing happened. Okay, so then I guess we're not ready. We apparently have things to do. Hello there, pony. Entry to the Elecon Princess Tea Party is only granted to those in Elecon cosplay. Oh boy. Nobody move! I lost the contact. Sorry, I have to move, otherwise we're never gonna finish this game. Hey Trixie. I hope Bulk downstairs is sleeping. Water will wake him up. Well, I already know that, but I couldn't go to him. Dragon, you're clear to go through. That's the Elecon amulet again, isn't it? Oh my gosh, your AK yearling. How'd you get in here? The signing isn't for another few hours. Oh, sorry, I'm part of the staff and I was just checking in. Is that so? Okay, could you throw this out for me? You got an empty cup. It's full of endless possibilities. Such as... I'll take this off your hooves. So, you're here for the convention too? No, I'm here for that Elecon Princess Tea Party later today. But your sponsor heard I was here, she made a panel for me. What's up with that tea party anyway? It seems like a big deal. Well, you want the long or the short story, kid? I did say you got a few hours. Cheeky. I hate cheeky. You see those on the table? That's the Elecon amulet. Got hired by the ponies running the tea party to find it. Turns out it doesn't like to stay in one place. Had to track down its former wearer first though. You mean Trixie? Not one to turn down a job opportunity that way. You'll probably see her around, paying her debts. The employers wanted to see an authentic Elecon artifact. Doesn't this belong in a museum or something? My thoughts exactly, kid. No, it belongs in a vault, safely locked away. That thing is bad. Watch yourself up there, kid. There's a cardboard box in this boot. Why? I don't know. But we now have a cup with endless possibilities, such as filling up water in it and giving it to Bulk so he won't sleep. So let's fill up the water. Alright, here it goes. Water! Give me that. Go. Yeah, I was totally not sleeping on the clock. Easy there, bro. Sorry, little dragon. It's hard to just stand there and stare at ponies. I bet it is. Anyway, I gotta check out the exhibit hall. Go on ahead. Alright, I mean, both biceps, you're like right there. A mere few steps from the water fountain. Why didn't you just go and have a drink? You fell asleep before that. I don't know. Alright. What's that? I don't know what you're supposed to be dressed up as. Lightning, maybe? I don't know. That might be a bit of a stretch. I don't know. Oh, hey, it's that pony that I couldn't remember the name of in the when I was playing Daydreaming Derby. Canny! Yes, I remembered her name. I feel proud of myself now. I can feel the company's eyes on me. Do you know a place where you can gala and or corn? Indeed. And that's Derby randomly appearing on the screen. Hey, Fluttershy. Stay up. Fluttershy, look up. Oh, hi Spike. I thought I would have to talk to strangers all day. Wow, did you make all these? Yes, but I haven't been able to sell anything yet. Are they not too overpriced? I don't think that's your problem there. Haven't you ever done this before? Oh no, this is actually my first time at the artist alley. Normally I would be too scared to do this by myself. But I wanted to try this at least once. Well, you practice on me. Try to sell me something. Okay. Stare. 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 Stare! Oh dear, that's... I don't know how to respond to this. Your face is missing. Ah! Yeah, my thoughts exactly. I'm so sorry. I freeze up when I'm put on the spot. Also, your face disappears. Was that your stare just now? I guess it was. Maybe that's why ponies just run away. Shiver. I feel something took a root in me. You got the stare. When you stare at the abyss stares back. That's scary. I can break up objects with the stare. I'll be more careful from now on. My stare is known to break things. I look this way, and when I walk away, it just goes up in smoke. You might want to get that checked. Could I ask you a favor, Fluttershy? Oh, of course. I'll be here all day. What is it? Could you make me an elegant princess bodysuit? For a friend. I'm working here today. I need it for a friend. It's fine, Spike. I could make it, but I need a few materials. First, I need some kind of cone shape for the horn. Get some kind of cone. Got it. These models are so cool, so bad I don't get paid for this. Aww. Alright, well, I'm looking for a cone, I guess. Oh dear. What is that? Is that a zombie spike statue thing? Ah. I do have a bag on here. I don't know if this is considered canon. It probably is not. Thank you for playing Spike's Day Out. Can you name all the references? In this room? Nope, nope, I cannot. So, go see where we are, if you want to, that is. What if we had a hat? Still the same. What if we go this way? Words cannot describe how much jet lag I have now. The same with or without the hat. Let's start with you. I wonder how the train is getting power. I wonder if there are any other special guests here today. Oh, little Pip. That's so cool. Oh, we got some wings. What are you? Wonder if the owner can give me these wings. Are you jumping on yourself? Pretty weird. We need to talk to the manager about this power problem. So, if I fix the power problem, maybe I will get the wings. But right now I'm still looking for a cone-shaped thing. That janitor over there looks like the clerk outside. These comments are totally not enchanted artifacts that suck you inside. That's good to know. I keep forgetting the manager's office outside, to the left. Hey, watch where you step. There's mob there. Sorry, Trixie. Shape. I need to go outside. Maybe just upstairs again. I also remember I can break things with my stare. And that's the teapot thing. Hello, Trixie. What if I break... Oh! So... I got got a cardboard box, the latest in tactical espionage tech. Should I break this? Probably not a good idea, you know, considering. Alright, I did get a cardboard box, I'm not sure what I'm gonna use it for yet, but I have it. Uh-oh. So... Cannot wear the hat anymore, this is the same command for the hat. I don't know, let me look for the cone shaped thing outside, maybe that's a traffic cone or something. Oh right, it's blocking the door, maybe I can stare into pieces, I can. Although, that means I now ruined Coco Pomel's armor, that was not very nice. Hey Trixie, it's not easy being the boss. Wait, are you the manager, the janitor, and the boss, and I don't know. So... Alright, well we found where the manager is. And how did that armor magically reappear? That is strange. Oh wait, could get a waffle cone if I had any here. Wait, a waffle cone? That's perfect, I think. The guy next to me stole my waffle cones. Hello, Mr. Hot Dog Guy. Did you? Hello? Anyone here? Oh wait. It's looking conspicuous to get food here. Spike, you're a cardboard box. Don't get more inconspicuous than this. Conspicuous even. Cardboard boxes are the highest form of stealth, and I have one right here. But can I do something? And is that a good barbecue corn? Alright, but... I want a waffle cone! Right, and I can only stare to the left, it seems. Oh, actually could. Oh, there's a cone! I got an ice cream cone! Why does an empty cone look so sad? It's because there's no ice cream in it. Alright, so now I have a cone for the unicorn horn, yeah? Let's go back up to Fluttershy, and she is all the way over here in the exhibition hall. Hey Kenny, hey Fluttershy, good, you're back. I got an ice cream cone here, is this okay? That's enough, just gotta shape this here. While you're here, is Twilight with you? Oh, it's just me today. Forgive me for asking, but does she know you're here? I'm sorry, I shouldn't have asked. Oh, it's fine, she doesn't know I'm here. We kinda had an argument. Oh my, I hope you patched things up with her. I plan to, but first I need to get her an apology gift. Well, I think it's great that you're helping ponies other than Twilight. You're making friends aside from her. Yeah, totally. And done. Okay, now I just need a pair of wings. Think you can handle that? Fake wings, of course. Right, right. Okay, well, I did see some wings and they were in the train, weren't they? I think. Yes. Wonder if the owner can give me these wings. Talk to the manager about the power problem, but we already found the manager and she had nothing to say, but does that mean we have to go back and talk to her now? That is not the right button at all. I was just having some tea and you just... Never mind. I don't know why I did that. The manager is hiding behind his suit of armor. Sabby. I say Sab. There we go. Hello. Are you eating all the power because of your microwave? Hey again, Trixie. Do you know where the manager is? Ah, Dragon. You're looking at her. But you were just outside and inside. On second thought, you were also at the exhibit hall too. Well, Trixie has had ample experience in many fields of work, of which includes sanitation, security, middle management. These jobs may or may not have been taken at the same time. Wait a minute. Did AK Yelling put you up to this? It is not nice to pry into a mayor's business. I just wanted to say, I think it's great what you're doing. Helping out other ponies on your own. It follows Trixie wherever she goes. Anyway, did you need something? Alright, there's a pony in the exhibit hall that needs more power. He can barely keep his boots light on. Trixie can't do anything about that. All the power is wired to other places. Besides, electrical engineering isn't on Trixie's resume. Is there another way to get more power? Well, most power is distributed to the food trucks outside. If just one of them were to close up for today... Okay, I'll go check on the food trucks. And back out we go. So how do we get one of these to close down? Well, there's no one at the... this one, is there? I already have a waffle. Or a cone. CMC, you can have a good corn. Smorgasbolta and meatballs, both are authentic breezy cuisine. What is smorgasbolta? I have no idea. It'd be a shame if this stopped working. So, are we supposed to... Sibity Sabbat? Okay, we are, apparently. Oh man, that's sabotage. I'm not sure what this game is trying to teach us. That eavesdropping and sabotage are okay, as long as you need to. Make your own ends meet, maybe. I don't know. Why did everything turn off? Because I'm a saboteur, apparently. Oh man, that's terrible. We are not setting a good example here. I'll just see if Trixie has anything new to say before we go back up to Fluttershy. No, not Fluttershy, the train store guy. Hey Trixie, the bubble tea truck just closed for the day. Oh, did it? Well, by the power vested in me as a janitor, clerk, security guard, and manager, I'll give that pony the power. Awesome, better tell him the good news. And Trixie?
Yes?
Believe in you. Alright. I'm still very morally confused about if what we're doing is right or wrong. Pretty sure it's not right. That probably means it's wrong. Right. And I know we are close to the 30-minute mark, which is where I usually wrap up my episodes. But I think we will just let this one run the course, and if not, if it turns out it's really long until the end, then I'll just cut it here and continue in the next episode, but I think we can finish this in this one. By the princesses, there's enough power for my train of the future. And as part of the staff, I reported your problem to the manager, and she was more than willing to help. Goodness, thank you. Please take this, my latest wing accessory. Hey, I got wings. Why do they feel so real? That's creepy. Thanks, it's the final piece for the Alicorn costume. final piece, eh? Maybe this will end sooner than I think. Right, I got the wings here. Okay, good. Did you dispose of the remains properly? Ah, that's creepy. What? I'm teasing. Oh, why are you? Apologize, I don't think normal ponies joke like that. Just stay out of her shit, okay? I'm practicing humorous small talk with my customers. I'll stitch the wings on now. And done. Spike, why don't you try it on? Fluttershy, I don't think this is a good place to. I insist, how will I know if my work was good or not? Really, Fluttershy, I'll just put it on later. Put it on now. Okay. That's surprisingly terrible. Congratulations, you are now an Elecon princess. Why doesn't it feel so cathartic? You look so precious. Well, now I can finally get into that tea party. Oh, why don't you show it off to everyone else? I'm sure they'll love it. The sooner I get to that tea party, the sooner I can get back to Twilight. Spike, maybe Twilight doesn't need an apology gift. Maybe she just wants to talk things out with you. Sigh. I don't think so. Just let me do this for her. Alright, so we have now... he looks so... I know... resigned to his fate when he's wearing that. It's like, alright, I guess I'm doing this. We need to get to the tea party that is here, I guess. Yes. Oh, nice costume. You're just in time for the tea party. I'll go in to announce your highness. Wait, I was just here for the ticket. Grumble. Smile and wave, Spike. Smile and wave. Dragon, how goes the shift? Hey, Trixie, what's it like in there? Pink, frilly, and full of princesses. Each one more stuck up than the next. All of them looking like they worked so hard for this. Trixie? It's not like there's plenty of other ponies who can actually work hard. And all they get at the end of the workday is a chance to see them. Trixie, stop ranting for a moment. There's the Elecon amulet sneaking closer to Trixie. That's probably a bad thing. You know, I like to think a mare like me deserves more. Is that so much to ask? Yep. He's wearing the Elecon amulet. What? Sorry to disturb you again. What did you say your domain of rule was? Trixie, where? Did you need some help, princess? Inhale. You should go back inside. There's only one Elecon princess that can help me. To be continued. Wait, what? Immediately! Yay! And then Trixie just sparked away. The Elecon amulet was probably drawn to her pent-up feelings. But I wouldn't worry too much about where she is. Why not? She clearly has a vendetta against the ponies here. Like I said before, we're inside a pocket dimension. Do you want to hear how I made it fit in this booth? Princess, I don't think now's the time for that. Think of it like a wibbly wobbly lost and found. She'll show up here eventually. There we go, Trixie! That's the great and powerful Trixie to you. Trixie, listen to me. Take that thing off. And go back to being a plain old employee of a pony? Princess, shh. This is some good drama. You don't know how insulting it is. Seeing the ponies here throwing their bits around like it's nothing. Saying things like, I might as well buy it because they could afford it. Trixie, that thing around your neck is messing with your head. Well, ponies like me can't afford anything. Because we spend our time, day in, day out, cleaning up after them. Rule number one. Respect for all ponies. Because everyone has a life outside the convention. Whether we like it or not. Rule number two. Have fun. Because it's nice to do something for yourself once in a while. But that's not how you make other ponies happy. What are you talking about, Dragon? And you may hate yourself for it, and that hate will follow you and take you to a bad place. But once you're there, you'll only want to go deeper. Didn't know you felt the same way. I didn't mean to come here today and help all those ponies. But I didn't expect to find a pony like you doing a better job than me. And I think you're pretty great, doing that despite how you feel. Aww, you gained a new friend. Misery loves company. Hey, the amulet is gone. Where'd it go? Did you take it off? Wait, the Elegant Princess Tea Party. Don't worry about that, kid. Pretty sure the employer understands a magical mishap. Phew. On the other hoof, you two owe me some sweat. Looks like your weekend just cleared up for me. Trixie never had a weekend to begin with. But at least it's not just me who's losing time. This year, Link, the tea party is getting out of hoof. The guests are now declaring their own sovereign states. Yeah! This is going into the photo album. Thank you for playing. Alright. There was a lot of those references I did not get, but at least I remembered the name of Kani this time. It's already late. I should really head home. Spike! Oh, it's Twilight. There you are, Spike. Twilight, I was looking for you all over. Please, don't just run off like that. I probably said some horrible things, and I'm sorry. Spike, you have to tell me what's wrong. Me too. I'm sorry for making you worry. I had a pretty crazy day. Can I tell you about it? Aww. Alright, I guess that's Spike's Day Out. And we have now played both of the games, and we should be ready for Spike's Time Off when that game is released. And I'm looking forward to it, because these are quite fun. I love these games. I mean, they could have a little more gameplay like Daydreaming Derby, but these are like short stories, I guess, that you just sort of experience. And I'm kind of okay with that, but I love Daydreaming Derby because that was also like a game with game mechanics. And I'm hoping Spike's Time Off will be the same. We'll see when it gets out. For now, thank you for watching, and Fizzban out. Nope. It's just the start. Nothing special. I just press spacebar. Anyways, what I was saying is, thank you for watching, and Fizzban out.